We are the San Patricios, a brave and gallant band. There'll be no white flag flying within this green command. We are the San Patricios. We have but one demand, to see the Yankees safely home across the Rio Grande.
So, you know, the Irish, of course, to shoot Catholics, you know, there were all these Protestant generals and that sort of thing. Right. They didn't, so they of course, crossed over into the Mexican army.
Right.
And, of course, as the story is told, they didn't win, but they stood to the very end and, yep. and stood their ground, and a lot of them were hanged, in fact, yeah. you know, which was a dreadful...
Dreadful. Horrible. While we've been working on this record, I've asked some friends to say, what are you doing? So, well, with Patty Maloney, we're working on this story. What's that? So, well, it's the San Patricios. Did you ever hear of this? Absolutely not. Do you know anything about the Mexican War? Well, no. Something about the Alamo, Davy Crockett, that was starring Fess Parker. And John Wayne. He said, yeah, but I don't mean movie history. The myth of nationhood and all this,
yeah, yeah,
which is strong and reinforced over time by films
yeah.
and popular
yeah.
media,
yeah.
And create this incredible, like, distorted view of it. Now, the great thing about a record like this is the people you meet, I suppose
yeah.
you could say. Now you're friends with them.
Yeah, well, had a ball.
So it brings people together.
Yeah, yeah.
And musicians yeah. like to get together, and yeah. this is what they like to
yeah.
do.
Yeah.
So the recording gives everybody an opportunity yeah. to do what they like to do.
Yeah.
Yo quiero luz de luna para mi noche triste. Para soñar divina la ilusión que me trajiste.
And you can feel that
oh,
it's
yeah.
not just another no. day in the life, another yeah. you know, commercial exercise for anybody. It has something
yeah.
more
oh, yeah,
going
personal,
for it to
yeah.
push it along.
Yeah.
Pues desde que te fuiste yo no he tenido luz de luna. Pues desde que te fuiste yo no he tenido.
Well, you know, we start kicked off the whole project with Leela Downs,
yeah.
a fantastic singer, and she is a great person to putting across the song. I had some of my dancers, the Pulaski brothers and
oh, yeah.
Cara Butler,
wow.
and Leela was doing her mm. dance because it's a traditional dance, you know, and it's
yeah.
in the Irish sort of. Jig, 6/8 rhythms and things like that. It was great having her dancing and the
and
two
them.
Dancers, Cara and John Pulaski, doing their bit of a dance as well, you know, all together. Exciting, you know.
Yes, I'm sure.
They have been playing the tin whistle a little bit better than usual.
So, Patty, you asked me mm-hmm. at some point when we were talking about this during the process, and you asked me what about the little lament song that I had tried to do in a film score, Canción Mixteca, the migrant song it is, How Far I Am from the Land of My Birth. I live without light, without love. I want to die of essentially homesickness.
Lejos estoy del suelo donde nacido.
I think every Mexican and every migrant knows this song, and everybody in the from that area, especially coming to Los Angeles or coming to California, coming to the United States, comes with this tune. It's like in your pack, you know. Yeah, it's like something you carry with you all the time. Yeah. They all know it, and everybody sings this tune. So we were talking about this, and I thought, well, let's have somebody really deliver this song. Let's have somebody really who feels it in their deep in their soul. Let's have them do it. Who could that be? Well, Los Tigres del Norte came up. Guys who came up dirt poor, guys who made the journey and played this tune and absolutely nailed it to the cross, and that is a great performance of that tune. It's a beautiful little song, and the lyrics are, if you flip it around, seems to me that the same could be said for these poor Irish soldiers who were so far from home, probably never going back, needless to say.
Yeah.
So for them, it's also true.
Yeah. Very much so.
You know, yeah, the diasporic person is never going to get back there. What is a border? The question is really
it, cool.
See, there's arbitrary lines.
Yeah.
The creation of the Mexican-USA border was something, it moved up and down and up and down the map for so many years.
Of course.
So it was so, what's the word, porous, you know?
Yeah.
People in Texas speaking Spanish, people in the Mexican side speaking English, now more than ever.
Yeah.
Now they've tried to put this wall up down there.
That's right.
And it is, of course, it's an insane act. It's a terrible thing.
Yeah.
You can't do that. It's not the way people are and countries really operate.
That's right.
It's terribly artificial to say this line you do not cross and so forth.
Yeah.
Los Angeles, where I'm from, is a Mexican town.
Sure.
And we're a few miles from the border, and every 80% now, I think, Spanish speaking. So everywhere you go, you hear this, always have.
Yeah.
And I think that the idea of combining with you to lead the idea off, the story is the sort of the little motor in the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And the wheels are going to be the Irish rhythms and the melodies grafted together with the Mexican stuff, which turns out to have all these cross currents.
Yeah.
And it's great to see it, and I know that it's vivid and exciting, and the future may rest with all of these Spanish-speaking people. There's so many, and they're coming up, and it's coming more into the minds of people to be interested in this kind of thing. Music is great because music goes to people's feeling, and their emotional response bypasses their training even. Oh, but I've been taught that Mexicans are second class. Well, if you lay one of these tunes on them, or they get to see Lila Downs, or they get to see Los Tigres, they don't think that way anymore. They end up realizing there's somebody here that I might like to be friends with, you know, and we might find that we have a lot in common, you know.
Yeah.
That's what this record is showing.